Good morning. Hi, Stella. So I'm getting ready for the day. I have an appointment today at 2 o'clock. So all this craziness going on in my life, personal stuff. So gotta get that taken care of. But I already did my eyes. That's actually pretty. You know how everything looks different than what it is on camera, so. Well, I'll post pictures of what it looks. It looks really good, though. I think I did a good job on it. Turn the music down a little bit. I dedicate this song to my husband, who is out in the field today. He's excited. He looked like a little boy about to ride a toy. Gets to go drive tanks today, so I'm pretty excited for him. I love seeing him happy. As corny as that sounds, I love seeing anybody that, you know, friends, family, whenever anything good is happening for them, it makes me happy. So, long time ago. Hold on. I really love that song. Alright, so anyways, this isn't really too much about makeup today, as I want to go over a few things, talk about a few things this morning. So if you want to join in, you're more than welcome to. So I was talking to a friend last night, and she, asked me, why does it always seem like her family's never there for her? And you know what's funny is that, because she feels like friends are more of her family than her actual family. And you know what, there's actual cases, I mean, like, people out there that has that. You know, me growing up, I didn't really have my family around because I raised myself at 16. So my family was my friends, right? Well, over the years, and as I got older, after having kids, I reconnected with my family, and, you know, and my family started just becoming more of my family, and my friends becoming just acquaintances, you know what I'm saying? So, oh, thank you. Thank you, Brandy. Makes me feel good. I love that. You're a very beautiful woman yourself. So, family, right? What is family? Well, I'll tell you guys a little story. So, every year, it's getting hot in here. Every year, and this is what I told her. I said, don't feel bad, you know, because sometimes the way that your family is not your fault, right? You are your own person. You may be born into a family, but that doesn't mean you are all going to be the same, right? Everybody's completely different. So, it's hot in here, and I love this song. All right, so I did that in my thing. Okay. I love this song. Have you guys seen this one? That YouTube, or I mean the Facebook, the dad, the Spanish looking dad, bald headed dad with his little pretty girl curly hair. Oh my god, he kills this song. Like, he's love it. I love it when people can mix that like R&B soul sound in their voice into country music. Thank you. I did not clean my brush like I wanted to. I'll get back to my story in a minute about the whole family thing, but you know, and I just thought of something else too that I wanted to talk about. Because it's very tough seeing any of my kids being very sad or upset. So, anyways, what I was saying, talking about. So I told her, my friend last night on the phone, I told her, do not be mad at your family for the way that they are, right? Because everyone's completely different. You could be the most loving person, and you could have family members that are like the most hateful people, right? Now, I can relate a lot to this because I go through this, right? I wear my heart out on my sleeves, right? And I mean, I can be one of the toughest people to deal with. And that's just being a female in general, but I could be very tough to deal with sometimes. But you know what? And I'm going to tell you guys this right now. When it comes to me, and I say this all the time, and I will say it till the day I die. I can be the biggest bitch, right? But you know there's one thing that you can always rely on from me? Is that I will be loyal to the max to you. And be straightforward to you, right? Because I don't like fake people. I cannot stand fake people. I cannot. I just don't. It's not in the time of day for me. I don't want to surround myself with people who are, if I turn my back, they're not going to say anything behind my back, right? So that's one flaw about me is being, I don't know if it's a flaw. But that's one thing about me, you know, like I'm very loyal to the max and I don't put up with the fakeness. I'm not going to be like, oh, hi to your face and I want to hang out and da 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 behind your back. I'm talking to my girlfriend saying I don't like that girl, right? I am not that way, right? I just don't, if I don't like you, I don't like you. I don't have a time of day for you. I'm not going to deal with you. So anyways, back to my story. Family members. And I'm not upset or mad because I will always love my family, each and every single one of them. I really will. And we're all different in our own ways, right? What we're either good at or what we're bad at or whatever, you know, and that's every family, right? Every family is different. But, you know, it got to me the other day because after you reach, I think, 21, birthdays aren't exciting anymore, right? Okay. And this is the story I was telling my girlfriend last night. So, it's just very hard because I always like tear up when I start talking about it. But I put my big girl panties on for this one. So, the thing is that no matter how bad we want, like some people want their family to be so connected, right? Like have that close-knit bond and that's what I definitely want from my family. But we're far from that. We really are. I mean, we've all been through like hell and back together. But we all drifted off in our own way. So, and I was telling my girlfriend last night, don't feel upset because you can be the kindest person in your family, right? And the most giving. And sometimes that snake can be a family member, you know? Not, it doesn't always have to be a friend. And people learn this, right? And you can either live with it as being mad and hating the world, or you could just let it go. And that's what I've learned to do, is let it go. I will always think of each and every single family member of mine, but I'm just not that close with any of them anymore. So, and I was telling her, because she's like upset, I said, let me tell you a story, right? My birthday was on the 11th, okay? And this, I mean, I started crying when I told her this because, you know, I'm a big cry baby, I'm a very emotional person. No matter how far apart me and my family members are, when it comes to any other birthdays or anything like big, I'm the type of person to reach out, send you a text, send you something on Facebook post, right? And if you think I'm lying, then go back on all my posts. Anytime it's their birthday or something significant, I always give like a shout out. I send my brothers or sisters a text, yada yada. Do you know how many people text me for my birthday? And this is what I told her last night. Do you know how many people text me on my birthday from my family? The only person that told me happy birthday from my family was my dad, my stepdad, right? And my brother-in-law. My own husband forgot about my birthday, right? So, you know, maybe whatever. Just give it till the end of the day, right? Now, by the time I did post something later on that night, thanking everyone that did say happy birthday to me, I finally got two other texts, right? Tell me happy birthday, or one was a message, one was a text. You know, and I'm not angry. I just feel like sometimes, like, why would I go out of my way telling you happy birthday, and I don't get that treatment back, you know? So I told her, don't be upset. Just remind yourself that. Just continue to be the good person that you are, you know? But don't let it get to you, because I don't. I really don't. Some family don't know really what family is, and that's okay. But, like I said, I don't really talk to any of my family anymore. I need to do concealer. That just, like, kind of threw off everything for me. But I just want to say that, you know, no matter how you are, why is it doing that? Never hate your family. Just love your family and continue to love your family. But don't ever let it get to you. That's basically what I'm trying to say. So, I hate talking about some stuff like that sometimes, but am I mad at my family? No, I'm not mad at my family. I love every single one of them. Blood or not in my family, I love every single one. And I always think of them from time to time. But do I have a close-knit family? No, I do not. And that's okay. Because you know who I have to worry about and making sure they're okay are my kids. And that's one thing about my, you know, my husband tells me is that I have such a big heart and I want to, like, fix everybody before I fix even myself. And I just have to learn to, like, let that go. I can't change everybody. I can't change my family a certain way, and I can only, like, wish the best for them. But, like I told her last night, I said, don't be upset that your family is the way that they are. Because, girl, I'm going through the same thing, too. Some of my family members treat other people more than what they're treating their family. And that's okay. Because the only person, she has kids, the only person you have to worry about, honestly, is your kids, right? It's not going to make you or break you if your sister, brother, or cousin, whatever, stops talking to you. If you have kids, focus on them. If you don't have kids, focus on yourself. You know? Because I can honestly say my 31st birthday was probably the most suckiest birthday I ever had. But I'm grateful I'm alive, and I'm grateful for my kids, and I'm grateful for my health, right? And the few close friends that I do have, and the wonderful friends I do have over the internet, through my job, and yeah. So, not everyone has a perfect family. Definitely not. And I think with my family is we've been through so much that everyone is always constantly blaming someone in this family of why they are that the way that they are and why their life is the way that it is. And you know what? Me, a lot of people, if you grow up at a young age without your family and you're basically kind of like living on the streets, bouncing from house to house, and you get involved in stupid things and do stupid things, right? A lot of those people don't mature and grow up, right? Like, they don't. And you know what? Me, I'm glad my life is a lot better than what it was. But I can tell you right now, whenever I was in that situation from 16 up, not once did I ever blame or put the blame on my mom or my dad of why my life is the way that it is, right? Because my mom and dad didn't force any of the stupid decisions I decided to do myself. And some of my family tend to do that. Like, you know, if my mom and dad didn't create such a hard life for us that, you know, things would have been different. You know, some of that might be true. You're right. We probably wouldn't have had a broken family or gone through all the stupid crap that we did. But it's up to you to make your life, and that's on you. Like, your bad decisions are on you. Not my mom or dad. Not my mom or dad. So. Now, powder. Where is my powder? Okay. So. Now, before I get into the last topic, because this is the one that's probably going to make me cry. I should probably do it before I even do my mascara. So something I realized is, and this is tip for, enough about family talk. I was like kind of all over the place with that one because I'm just watching what I say because I'm not trying to upset anybody or make anyone hurtful. I'm just kind of like stating the truth, you know? Every family is different. And I told my girlfriend last night, do not be upset for the family you were born into. You could be the most giving, kind-hearted person, and your family will still treat you like crap, no matter what. So, and people, you know, will put others before their family. And that's something that's okay, because you know what? The only person that's like building your life and creating a good life for you is yourself, right? Because like I said, for the longest time growing up, I didn't have my family. I had my friends. I raised myself. I didn't have mom and dad to take care of me and, you know, I got my first job at 16 and I just had a job ever since. So, I mean, it was tough, really tough, and it sucked because, like, no, it doesn't matter how old you are and, like, deep down, everybody wants, like, a mom or dad there, you know? And I didn't have that growing up. So, my friends were my family at that time. Now that all my family are kind of, like, semi-back together, kind of, I want nothing more for my whole family just to be close and, like, you know? But it's not. We're all so broken in our own way, or, you know, even broken by the crowd or people that were around. And, you know, my one sister lives in freaking Washington, so far away. And then, you know, we're just all broken in our own way. So nobody has a perfect family. And that's what I told her last night. Don't get upset for your family members for, you know, the reason why that they are the way that they are, okay? Because I can get upset all day long, but, you know, after I told her the story that, you know, my birthday the other day, none of my family told me happy birthday. My stepdad in the morning did, but no one told me happy birthday until later on that night after I posted on Facebook that, you know, I'm thankful for everyone saying happy birthday, and I don't care for those who didn't. because like I said, no matter, I may not talk to you every day, and but if you were close to me at one point, or even my family every year when it's your birthday, I said happy birthday, whether it's on Facebook, by text, that. So that story like made her feel kind of shitty, because you know she feels selfish for thinking the way she does, because you know at least her family tells her happy birthday. So, but like I said, I'm not upset or mad. Everyone's caught up doing their own thing, living their own life. Do I wish I had a better connected family? Yes, I do. But I just don't. But that's why I'm going to raise my kids to have like that close-knit bond, you know, between us. Cause I want nothing more than just a close family, you know? Big family functions. Like that's how my family's gonna be. It's not gonna be broken. It's not, I'm hoping it's not. I can't predict the future, but I'm hoping it's not. I love my husband very much. I love my kids very much, so it sucks that I don't have a close family, and we're all kind of near each other besides one all the way off in Washington, but whatever, you know? All right, so I did that. What time is it? Can't see the time, it's not on my phone. So enough about family talk. Let's go into the next thing. So before I get into this topic about one of my kids, something I realized yesterday, right? And I wanted to share with you guys today. For any of my people on my friends list that are online marketers or whatnot, this isn't about my job. I mean, it kind of is, but I'm not talking about joining my team or anything like that. But so I started using Instagram, right? I've been using Instagram, but I started like posting about my job and, you know, the great opportunity on my Instagram. Well, I guess I didn't realize that if you're not my friend on Instagram, that it sends like your messages that people send to you. You have to request, it's not in your inbox. There's like a request. It says like two message requests or one message request or whatever it is. Well, I was messaging one of my friends. Was it Brittany I was messaging? I don't know if it was Brittany or I was messaging someone yesterday. And I was messaging someone yesterday. Then I realized I had 5 message requests, right? And it was all about information about my job. And I was like, holy crap. And they've been sitting, like the last one that was sent was like last Saturday. I'm like, oh my God, I can't believe I'm not like checking this crap. So I probably just like missed out on some sales right there, because they're like probably thinking, why isn't this girl like wrote me back? But I didn't realize that. So my whole point of the story is, if you're running a business, whether you're running a business here in town or online, use all your social media platforms, y'all. I'm telling you, use it all. Use Instagram. I just started using Pinterest. I started making my boards and pins yesterday. Pinterest. I'm going to open up a Twitter. Like, you know what I'm saying? So if you run a business online or in store here or whatever, or you know people, tell them, use every social media platform. It's like there at your hands and fingertips. Use it, because those 5 messages asking about my job or, you know, how to get on my team and make money, like, that's awesome. And, you know, that's just from, like I said, that's one thing I love about my job. I don't have to chase people. People come to me. You know what I'm saying? That's like, because I'm not the type of person, I'm not a pushy person. Before I even signed up about this, and that was one of the questions I asked my sponsor, like, am I gonna have to like go out and like talk to people or like, you know, like chase after people? She said, no, that's the great thing, right? You advertise, market yourself, people come to you wanting to know. So that's what I love. So my main point of that was, if you run any business online, in store, in person, if you know anybody that's running any business, I don't care. It could be online or here in Jacksonville. I don't know, but tell them. Use every social media platform you can. The more people out there that see your stuff, the more you're going to generate sales. So I'm pretty excited because I had 5 in my Instagram message request. So that makes me happy. All right. So last but not least. Put that back. Sorry, guys. Just feel like I've been sick forever. Tennessee. I think I'm going to use my Lord blush today. All right. Last thing I wanted to talk about. So I talked about family. Every family is different. Can't hate your family if they don't talk to you. Then I talked about network marketing. Use every social media outlet you can or platform you can. Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Pinterest. Like, I didn't even know you could do that on Pinterest. I just, like, learned that the other day. So. Okay. So, last thing I want to talk about. Actually, before I get into that last one, because the last one I want to talk about is like pretty deep, because it's about one of my kids. But anyways, one of my members I was talking to, she asked me how she could get more signups or like more people to her page. So one of the topics was, one of the things I brought up was, I asked her, "Are you doing live videos?" She said no. I said, "Why aren't you doing any live videos?" Because she's posted videos only on her Facebook work page. She's too nervous and too scared. And that's why I posted that one guy that I follow, the effing guy. I don't know if y'all seen that. I posted it on my page. But it was a big coincidence because I was just talking about that yesterday. You know, live videos are your best friend, right? Do you think I really care how many people actually watch all my live videos? Or I do care, but do you think I care what people are actually thinking about me when I'm doing my live videos, right? Was I nervous as heck in the beginning of doing live videos? Yeah, I was, right? Because I'm like, oh, they're probably going to think, you know, oh, she doesn't know what she's talking about. She doesn't know what she's doing with her makeup, you know, but you know what? Everybody is like judgmental in their own ways, right? So not everyone's gonna like the same thing as you. I got over my jitters of doing live Facebook videos, and I told her, start doing live videos on your personal page. Get people to know you, you know? You may have gone to high school with these people, but you think you're still that same person back in high school? No, I'm definitely not. Definitely not. So, if you're nervous about doing live videos, don't be. Get it out. Just get it over with. Do your first one and just talk about whatever. I don't know. Whatever, like, makes you happy or what do you do, you know? Like, just get it out. Do it. You gotta get past that, you know? You want people to know you and get seen more, you know? Start from somewhere. So even when, I told her, when you do your live videos, don't pay so much attention to how many numbers are up there on the live, like who's actually watching. Don't worry about that. Just do you. Do you. Get your video out there. You know, people might not be awake or whatever. They'll come see your video afterwards. You never know, right? Just be you. Don't be scared. Who cares what others think? Is everyone else paying your bills, or is everyone else, like, you know, taking care of your kids or raising your kids? No. Do live videos. I love doing them now. You know, I don't feel as nervous anymore, as like sweaty. And so it's just a big coincidence that I seen that, you know, the Trey guy, the network marketer coach, I seen his video last night. I just like laughed my butt off because I'm like, holy crap, I was just talking about that earlier, you know. And that's why I do live videos. And I don't care who gets annoyed how many live videos I do a day. You don't like it, unfriend me. I don't care. Like, you know, I enjoy doing live videos now. Like, I may not, like, it's not always about my job. I just like doing it because I like doing it, you know? It's fun. I don't get to have adult entertainment or interaction every day. So if I can have, like, adult entertainment talking to myself right now, then that's what I'm going to do. So, okay. I need to hurry. Last topic I wanted to talk about today. And this one, I really hope it doesn't make me cry. So, some of you guys might know what I'm talking about when I refer to this. I'm going through some personal stuff right now that I'm not going to talk about on the internet because I'm not allowed to, but it's affecting one of my kids and she's very sad, right? I'm going to do my eyebrows and my blush. Why did I do that? See? Oof. Anytime I see any of my kids, like, sad or hurt, it hurts Mama Bear, right? It really hurts me. Like, I want nothing more to take any sadness, any pain that any of my kids feel, right? And it's just very, very hard because sometimes I don't know what to say or what to do. Right? Do I just like let her be on her own and just feel it on her own? Or like, I don't know what to do or what to say, right? Because me growing up, my parents didn't talk to me like that. They saw me upset, they didn't talk to me like that. So I was just so used to like bottling up everything on my own, but that's something I don't want my daughter to have to go through, right? Hold on. But it just sucks that having to go through this and seeing her sad or upset, because this is something I don't even want to be happening right now, right? But things happen because they happen, whatever. But I just wish sometimes I knew the answer of what to do. So, let me get my son real quick. Hold on. Come on, come inside here.
What the hell are you doing?
Mom, I gotta go to the appointment later on. So, what do you say to an 8-year-old little girl, you know, that's like upset and sad and it's hard for me. Great. I'll fix that in a minute. You know, like, what do I say? What do I say to her? Sorry, I had to move because my light can't see. It's just sucky, because this isn't like something I want to like be even experiencing myself, you know? Just sucky. And this is like one of those situations that I wish I did have my family there for me on this. Like, besides, you know, like my mom and dad here, but I feel like with this stuff going on, and that's, I don't even want to get into it. This is just going to make me mad. Because, like, you know, I could tell you right now, if any of my family members were going through something like this, I'd be there for them. But that's why I say you can't get mad. You can't judge your family. They are their own people, you know? Why do you have that? Are you gonna do makeup? So yeah, I hate seeing any of my kids like upset or sad, you know? Upset or sad, you know, like, what do I say, you know? Crap. Like, I don't want to be going to this thing today. Ugh. You guys don't understand, like, sometimes I just, like, oof. I so can't wait till, like, everything comes out, like, y'all don't even know. Can't wait. Don't mess your eyes. He's a beautiful man. How many of y'all think Keith Urban's one sexy man? He is, well, sexy after my husband, but blue ain't your color. Go back in with more eyeshadow. Son here is playing with the beauty blender. Where are you going? Stay here. And hang out with Mama. Mama, he's playing with my beauty blender. I guess that's a way of fixing up my one spot on my eyebrow. Good. Where are you going? What happened to my top? Did you do something with my top? Tristan.
Huh?
Yeah, my top. Did you touch it? Hey, boy. Why? Did you touch mommy's top? Tristan, oh, nah, just kidding, I'm sorry, mommy didn't mean that. I think it, woman, you're crazy. It's not a ball. It's not a ball, baby. Say please. Can you say, tell everyone please? Say please. No? Okay. Crap, where is this? Another day. That's good. It's good enough for Mama. It's just eyebrow gel. Can you just smack my butt? Don't be touching anything else. No. Here, you can touch that. Go over there. Watch mommy. Yeah, watch mommy. Okay. Don't put that in the toilet. Hear me? Don't. That's good. No. Oh my God, my eyeshadow actually looks really good today. No, that's your baby brother's bathtub or bathing. I love this Urban Decay eyelash curler. Yeah, watch out. Here, give me that. Yeah, no, can't touch that. We gotta hurry. So this is the Lorac 3D. Oh, the brave. I wonder what's that about. Interesting. Let's use this. Ah, forgot to put my mascara primer thing on. That's great. This is a little trick for you guys. This is just a small piece, a little box, plastic piece. Because you know how when you do your mascara, it gets onto your... It gets on this instead of your eyelid where you just did your... Oh, great. Yeah, see? And you gotta be careful when you do that too. That's why I did the one. That's good. Wait, what are you doing? No, that don't go in your mouth. That's a no-no. You're gonna get sick. Don't put that in your mouth. Here. Use this. There you go. Falsies. I do not want to go to this place today. I don't want to do any of this crap. Which eyelashes should I use? Blush. Oh, bless you. What? Alright, let's try these out. The $5 box. I don't need nothing too crazy today, because Mama... Alright, we'll do this one. Tristan, no. That's mommy's. No, don't. You can't do that. You're gonna break it. Oh no. Don't touch that. You're gonna break that, baby. You can't break that. That's mommy's only computer. This is from the Five and Below store, so. Yeah, hold on. Stop. No. No, here. Play with this one. That one. There you go. Go throw that one in the trash. Throw that in the trash for mommy. That one. See that one? No, not that one. This one. That one. Throw that in the trash. Yeah, throw that in the trash, mommy. No, that. Throw that. Hi, Ashley. Yeah, throw that one in the trash for mommy. Okay? No, it's not bad.
Yeah, boy.
Oops. Don't touch that. No. No. Go over there. What'd you do with that bottle, Tristan? Oh, it's right there. Yeah.
What?
you guys love wearing eyelashes, I'm telling you, order from House of Lashes. House of Lashes or Lashes in a Box. It's like the best eyelashes ever. No. Smoky mirrors. Got three. Go get your other brother. Got some running around to do. No. I'm just waiting till this dries out. Just a little bit, just need a little sticky. I don't mean look too crazy because this place is like, why are you coming here looking like this? Because I want to? This eyeshadow is really pretty. I didn't use the Carly by Belle palette today. I used the, what are you doing? No. I used the, what's this? The TARDIS Pro. Oh, have you guys seen the new Tarte palettes? Freaking toast it. I'm getting them. Hey, No. Go over there. Go over there. Stop touching that. Light. See that lashes are okay. They're not what's it called? They're okay. Doing? No. can't mess this up. Yeah, no, no, no. Oh my goodness, boy. No. It's expensive, dude. Can't do that. Alright, I need to go over with... curler. It's not a hairbrush. You hear me? I saw you. This is a sad music video. Have you guys ever seen that music video, Little Rascals? What hurts the most? I used to cry every time I watch it. I'm like, oh my god, that is so sad. Where's my mascara? I want to blend in your real lashes with the fake. So my verdict on the 5 and below lashes are okay. Not the best. Yeah. How are you doing, boy? I'm just wiping away the dropout, fallouts. Okay, okay. I just use the NYX Milk Jumbo pencil. No, stop. No. 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 Great, I just dropped all that. Alright, now I'm gonna go in with highlighter. I'm actually not gonna do the cream highlight today because I don't need to go too crazy. Stop. So I have to look somewhat decent at this place. Let's go in. This highlight. This is the Carly by Belle Deluxe with the eyeshadows and highlight. Stop. No. Stop touching that. Stop. You're not putting makeup on yourself, boy. Goodness, you are a boy. No, no, no. Alright, I'm just going with this. Ooh, I didn't have to put on cream for this one. Look at that. Wow. Look at that. I didn't even have to put on cream for this one. That's beautiful. Oh my gosh. Still growing strong. Tristan, no. No, no, no. This kid feels like he has to get to everything. Everything. I think I overdid a little bit today. Oh well. Stop touching that. No, 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 no. That's computer. This kid feels like he has to touch everything. Like he just can't sit still either. No. Sorry, guys. I know, we're about to go bye-bye. Hold on. I ain't creamed up. Saying should have left it matte, not gloss. Oh well. Oh well. Go ahead and go. So that was a good talk this morning. Yeah. Oh, don't touch that. I definitely have to clean brushes later. Can you remind me to brush Clean the brushes later, baby. Yeah? Oh, you said yeah. Look at that. Yeah, you have my back. You have my back. You know that? No, do not want to talk to you. Don't pick up numbers I don't know. Do I have everything? Does mommy have everything? Yeah. It. I'm done. Shouldn't have probably done that much, but this place is gonna look at me like I'm crazy. I'm like, girlfriend, where are you going? Right? Say hi to everybody. Say hi. Say hi, everybody. Can you say hi to everybody? All right, see you guys later. Love this. Got to get this.